Breaking news, violent protests, running street battles breaking out.
27 victims, 20 children, 7 adults.
Allegations of hazing on the team.
Escape killers from New York.
One of the most dangerous schools in this country.
Kids were violated.
Outrage over the racist chant.
In the streets, blocking the roadway.
It's going to get very bad here.
Nearly 4,500 inmates died while in police custody.
And you could hear, like, bombs and shotguns going off. And then he came into the library and shot everybody around me.
God bless America, we're the land of the free.
But tell that to the world's largest prison population with young drug offenders in prison with lawyer fees, minimum wage workers trained to be slaves. Can I take your order, please? But they're lazy, unlike you and me. Or maybe they couldn't afford what it takes to get a college degree. Maybe they didn't grow up in the same streets we're accustomed to seeing. But too bad they didn't get that university paper they tell us is so freeing, freeing. Tell that to my friends who have to choose between paying college debts and eating. If a college degree means breathing, I guess breathing means suffocating. They say a lack of money is what breeds troublemaking, but there's a reason troublemaking makes the money that's lacking. But the rich get richer and the funds keep stacking, and the poor get poorer and some keep laughing. But laughter is happy, and America celebrates the pursuit of happiness. I doubt the founding fathers imagined this. Celebrities created by homemade movies on their bedroom mattresses. No fear of God or what happens after this. You see, the American dream is tragic. Get money, have kids, marry the hottest spouse. Get a divorce and split for the South. Find a love young interest and split for the South. Face God's wrath and get spit from his mouth. But why does God matter when we're all created by matter? You're here on accident. Now be a good clone and climb the corporate ladder. And the media wants to divide us between police officers and Black Lives Matter. Our population has been scattered and the economy shattered, but we're too busy online. Like, you like my post? Wow, I'm flattered. You see Hollywood rallies for women while beating them in their movies and leaving them battered. Am I the only one that sees hypocrisy in all of their chatter? But thank God we have political personalities who will save the day. Let me know when they do, because I'll save the date. If you put your faith in a party, I'm jealous of your faith. I tune into political debates and see podiums with fakes. I don't support Trump or Hillary Clinton or any other politician I forgot to mention. I imagine this poetry just caused a whole lot of tension, but you'd be better off taking that tension and rallying for wounded vets who never got granted their pension. How can you be free in a society that keeps you fenced in, pumping endless vaccines into innocent infants, but they lost their rights way back? Abortions by the millions, but I'm not supposed to say that. You're a middle-class white boy, just lay back. You've got it made, and your parents probably drive a Maybach. White privilege, what's that? It's just another scheme to pin whites against blacks. But lately it feels like some judge my skin color like I'm responsible for slavery. Pray for me. But on those segregated buses, I would have said, trade me seats. I'll sit in the back because I see you equally. White doesn't mean racist and black doesn't mean thief. A few fools got a stereotype by covering their faces in their mom and dad's bed sheets. But it's not okay, KKK, to label me because of them. And I won't label you because of the pigmentation of your skin. Because when ignorance corrupts your thinking, nobody wins. Except for the instigators with childish grins. This is a collect call to the White House. Yo, dial me in. If you didn't work for a party, would you lie to us then? Yeah, that probably would, because this is the home of the grave and the land of the greed. Still a country I'd die for, I'd suffer and bleed, because patriotism was ingrained in me. But in 2016, that's getting harder to see. With every lie uncovered, I find it harder to believe. And there's a million others in my generation just like me who want someone to look up to inspire and lead, because it's bigger than gun control and legalizing weed. When we have kids in our inner city starving in the streets, but they'll beat a new drum and we'll march to the beat. United States zombies trained to not think. When we have teachers that command us to fill out their sheets. You come from monkeys and there is no God. Then kids shoot up their school and we find it odd. But it's okay, because we'll throw a prayer vigil in the parking lot. 2 weeks later, more students get shot. And I'm just sitting back thinking, when will all this stop? And others shift blame and attack the cops. It's the boys in blue and it's all their fault. Everything honorable in this country is under assault. But God bless America, or so we're taught. But how do we expect God to bless the same things he said he will punish? It's rubbish. Rebels to God, and we love this. And I don't need a PhD to understand that blasphemy doesn't mean blessings. Clayton, quit stressing. Just close your eyes and start resting. But my eyes are too open to close them now. I put my faith in Jesus, not your NASDAQ or Dow. Keep your Wall Streets. I'm investing in a place with no walls around its streets. White privilege didn't get me to my Savior's feet. You see, I'm just like America. I'm broken and lost. But thank God Jesus paid that cost. And if America wants change, it starts at the cross.
And now for something completely different.
Completely different. completely different.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are tonight's entertainment.
A disgusting thing that he said, and I could tell you I would not use that word.
Talk about the pot calling the kettle orange. Listen to this.
But it's political bullshit.
She said he's a pussy.
They're ripping the shit out of the sea.
We can't get a fucking school built in Brooklyn.
You're not gonna raise that fucking price, you understand?
I'm gonna bomb the shit out of them.
Listen, you motherfuckers, we're gonna tax you 25%.
Yes, something certainly has changed in American political discourse.
Out of sheer morbid curiosity, I'm allowing this freak show to continue.
I will be the greatest jobs president that God ever created. I tell you that. I'm really rich. I'll show you that in a second. I have a total net worth, and now with the increase, it'll be well over $10 billion. But here, a total net worth of $8 billion. Net worth, not assets, not liability, a net worth.
Drowning deep in my sea of lonely, broken, your servant I am.
Free trade can be wonderful if you have smart people, but we have people that are stupid. If you really love this country, you have a very, very hard time convincing people that what you're doing is right and that you're really smart. And like a lot of us are really smart. I'm really smart. Went to the Wharton School of Finance. Even then, a long time ago, like the hardest or one of the hardest schools to get into. Did well at the school. Came out, made a fortune. Wrote a book called The Art of the Deal. Did everybody read The Art of the Deal? When do we beat Mexico at the border? They're laughing at us. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists.
Mexico doesn't want people. They're forcing them into our country. And we're taking them and we're putting them in our jails and our hospitals. And we're paying them money through different sources. It's a disgrace.
I would build a great wall. And nobody builds walls better than me, believe me. And I'll build them very inexpensively. I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
Yeah.
Mark my words.
Yeah.
And they're not sending us their best and their finest. You heard my speech. But how are you going to get Mexico to pay for a wall? You have people like we have. You're dopes. Calling them an enemy, aren't George, you? George, Mexico does not like us. Mexico is not our friend. Mexico is the new China. Mexico will pay. You mark my words. I win. Mexico pays. They love me, I love them. And I'll tell you something, if I get the nomination, I'll win the Latino vote. I will win it.
They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists. And I can tell you, some of the candidates they went in, they didn't know the air conditioner didn't work. They sweated like dogs. They didn't know the room was too big because they didn't have anybody there. How are they gonna beat ISIS?
But Mr. Trump, you're not a nice person.
That's true, but actually I am.
Get down with the sickness. Open up your hate and the never wanna make. Get down with the sickness. You
I'm going to let him live in his alternative reality.
I think I'm the only one that's going
to
beat
him. To his own record, he screams, liar, liar,
what
liar.
I said on Univision because he doesn't speak Spanish.
He's the biggest liar. This guy
no!
lied.
I can't take it.
Honey, what's wrong?
I'm hyperventilating. I can't take it anymore. Basic manners are gone from politics. What is it with these ding-dongs?
I will
What makes America the greatest country in the world? Why is America
not the greatest country in the world, Professor? That's my answer.
And yeah, you, sorority girl.
Just in case you accidentally wander into a voting booth one day, there's some things you should know. And one of them is, there is absolutely no evidence to support the statement that we're the greatest country in the world. We're 7th in literacy, 27th in math, 22nd in science, 49th in life expectancy, 178th in infant mortality, 3rd in median household income, number 4 in labor force, and number 4 in exports. We lead the world in only 3 categories. Number of incarcerated citizens per capita, number of adults who believe angels are real, and defense spending, where we spend more than the next 26 countries combined, 25 of whom are allies. Now, none of this is the fault of a 20-year-old college student, but you nonetheless are, without a doubt, a member of the worst period generation period ever, period. So when you ask what makes us the greatest country in the world, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Yosemite?
We need somebody that can take the brand of the United States and make it great again. It's not great again.
You know, and
she used to be great. She's still very beautiful.
I moved on her, actually. You know, she was down in Palm Beach. I moved on her, and I failed. I'll admit it.
Whoa.
I did try and fuck her. She was married.
That's huge news, Sarah.
No, Nancy. Yeah. No, this was marriages. And I moved on her very heavily. In fact, I took her out furniture shopping. She wanted to get some furniture. I said, I'll show you where they have some nice furniture. I took out furniture. I moved on her like a bitch, but I couldn't get there. And she was married. Then all of a sudden, I see her. She's now got the big phony tits and everything. She's totally changed her look.
You've never asked God for forgiveness. Do you regret making that remark?
No, I have great relationship with God. I have great relationship with the evangelicals. In fact, nationwide, I'm up by a lot. I'm leading everybody. But I like to be good. I don't like to have to ask for forgiveness, and I am good. I don't do a lot of things that are bad. I try and do nothing that's bad.
The prophecy is upon us.
Main story tonight, and I cannot believe I'm saying this, is Donald Trump. And I say that knowing that every time his name is said out loud, he has a shattering orgasm.
Please welcome the second worst tragedy ever to hit New York City. Ladies and gentlemen, Donald J. Trump.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am officially running for President of the United States, and we are going to make our country great again.
It's pronounced, I am fucking delusional, not I am running for president.
It's impossible.
Is it? Or is it so possible that your head is spinning like a top?
It can't be.
Can it? Or is your entire world just crashing down all around you?
All right, that's enough.
Yeah!
So anyway, Donald Trump. Now, don't get me wrong. He's a lot of fun. There's a little bit of me. There's a little bit of me that when, that thinks, fuck it, let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it and see how fucking crazy shit can get.
I like China. I just sold an apartment for $15 million to somebody from China. I love the Saudis. Many are in this building.
I would get along with Putin. I've dealt with Russia.
Won't be using a man like Secretary Kerry. He goes into a bicycle race at 72 years old and falls and breaks his leg. I won't be doing that. The American dream is dead. But if I get elected president, I will bring it back bigger and better and stronger than ever before, and we will make America great again. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Donald say he wants to run for president and move on into the White House. Why not? It wouldn't be the first time you pushed a black family out of their home.
But folks, our country right now is in a very bad spot. You can feel it, and you can see it everywhere. There's no stability. Nothing seems right. And all the things that we hold dear are being attacked every single day. We cannot go down this road anymore. We need to stop. We need Donald Trump to fix this. Is Donald Trump a messiah? No. He's just a man. A man who wants to give back to his country, America. Did you read the news today? They say the danger's down our way. But I can see the fire's the light. Burning into the night. The country that has given him everything. A country that has also given all of us so much. And now it's time to give back to her. A man doing this from the goodness of his heart and genuinely wants to help. A man who knows how to get things done. A man who says what he means and means what he says.
Because what happens is he says really simple shit that means nothing, and then fucking dummies, right? If you've ever said this sentence, "I like him because he's a straight talker," you're as dumb as shit.
We like him. He tells it like it is.
He says what he means. I honestly believe he's telling the truth.
He's funding his own campaign. Nobody owns him.
He's aggressive, and he's strong, and he's bold.
I think he's an incredible businessman. If he runs the country like he runs his organization, we would be in good shape.
Just because someone says something simple that you understand doesn't mean they're a straight talker. You can say complex thing and be telling the truth. But like, because he goes, "I'm gonna make America great again." And you're like, "I got every word in that sentence."
Donald Trump wants to be president for all of us. So of course, let's make America great again. But let's make America, America again.
Donald Trump can seem appealing until you take a closer look. Much like the lunch buffet at a strip club, or the NFL, or having a pet chimpanzee. Sure, it seems fun, but someday Coco's gonna tear your fucking limbs off.
Well, I thought I'd give you a call and give you some advice.
I don't understand. Why would you want to help me become president?
Because it'd be hilarious. Look, I've been president for 8 years. I'm ready for some entertainment. I just want to grab some popcorn, sit back, and watch this whole show go down.
I do understand why Trump supporters might like him. He's unpredictable and entertaining. Just look how he went after Marco Rubio on Friday.
Did you ever see a guy sweat like this? It's Rubio! That's what it...
That's objectively funny.
I've been waiting my whole life for just one. Bah! And all I needed was just one. Bah! And can you say that you don't give up? Bah! On my sales stupefied, I'm in back again. All I wanted was just one. Bah! One tiny little innocent. Bah! When I feel like I'm shocked out of luck. On my sales stupefied, I'm in back again. Why do you like the hand around?
I am officially running for President of the United States, and we are going to make our country great again.
He's confident.
Everybody seems to think I won the debate.
He's outspoken.
We can do a wall. We're going to have a big, fat, beautiful door right in the middle of the wall, and Mexico's going to pay for the wall.
Got to build a wall. Mexico's going to pay for it. Well, I haven't heard a Mexican yet go, oh, yeah, we got this. What are you talking about? What the fuck are you talking about? That's just saying shit. He's like a kid running for class president who's just walking around going, and we're going to have two lunches? And...
I mean, he's so blatantly stupid. He's a punk. He's a dog. He's a pig. He's a con, a bullshit artist, a mutt who doesn't know what he's talking about, doesn't do his homework, doesn't care, thinks he's gaming society, doesn't pay his taxes. He's an idiot. Colin Powell said it best. He's a national disaster. He's an embarrassment to this country. It makes me so angry that this country has gotten to this point, that this fool, this bozo, has wound up where he has. He talks how he wants to punch people in the face. Well, I'd like to punch him in the face.
Some say he's not presidential material.
I like people that weren't captured, okay? I hate to tell you.
I think he's an ass.
Others are ready to elect him tomorrow.
He's not a politician.
Let him know what you think of Trump.
He has a style that people want now. They're tired of politically correct. They're tired of the BS.
Republican frontrunner Donald Trump is seeing his favorability soar.
Everybody loves me. Everybody loves me.
Whether he's seen as the second coming of Ronald Reagan.
Make America great again.
Make America great again.
Or just a pitch man building his brand.
He's a guy who was born on third base and has been telling everyone he hit a triple.
Donald Trump's bid for the White House may be the most compelling campaign in recent memory.
We'll be back.
He knows how to play the media like a cheap fiddle.
Did you ever see a guy sweat like Rubio? I've never seen anything like that.
And it's a political odyssey 40 years in the making.
Maybe I'd run for president. I don't know.
To understand Donald Trump, the politician.
Wait!
First, you have to understand the man behind the brand.
I will be the greatest jobs president that God ever created.
All right, gentlemen, thank you. Please go to your podiums. That was awkward as you.
August 6, 2015, the first Republican debate.
Florida Governor Jeb Bush.
Jeb Bush, once the presumptive nominee, takes the stage. The former Florida governor is armed with a staggering $114 million war chest.
I hate you too.
And the weight of a political dynasty behind him. Yet, to the record 24 million people watching the debate at home, Jeb Bush is not the main attraction.
I think the big problem this country has is being politically correct.
It's Donald Trump, a brash kid from Queens, who's spent a lifetime driving to be the best at everything he's tried.
We're all here to play the game, and
The people that enjoy it are the people that are going to win it.
Now we're going.
And those who know the Donald say he's had his eye on the White House for a very long time.
Do you have the genes to be a successful politician?
Well, you never really know. I think I'm pretty outspoken, and that's not probably a good thing in terms of a politician, but it's a good thing if you ever got elected, you can really do a job.
And then I'm going to take all the drug pushers in our country, and I'm going to f*** them!
Why do you know those people in Syria? I'm going to f*** them!
That's why I will make sure that every terrorist on Earth is f*** dead!
Leaders of North Korea, I'll f*** them all, yeah!
Yeah, those ads that are trying to kill us, I'll f*** anyone in the advertising business! They'll all die too!
Until recently, much of the political establishment dismissed Donald Trump as a sideshow rather than a serious candidate.
He is without substance when one scratches below the surface.
If I were Hillary's team and I had $1 billion to throw at somebody, I'd pay Donald Trump to do exactly yes. what he's doing right now.
Trump's throwing this. You know he's throwing it. You know it. Have you figured this out yet? Have you seen it? Call it what you want. An inside job, a conspiracy. Come on. He's throwing it.
But a growing army of Trump's supporters feel he speaks for them.
Let's make America great again!
He said, the way that people run for president is going to change forever. I'm going to change everything.
On the campaign trail, he taunts his opposition.
By the way, he's registered zero in the polls. Zero. They said to Marco Rubio, are you having fun? He's sweating like a pig. I never saw a guy sweat like this. The sweat is pouring down.
But Trump seems to care little about whom he offends or what his detractors think. And apparently, neither do the voters he's targeting.
Is the little one supporting Trump as well?
Yes, she is.
By the time the August 6th debate ends, Trump's poll numbers spike even higher, leaving his Republican rivals in his jet wash. The more controversy he courts, the more energized his base seems to get.
He's gonna build a wall to keep all the illegal immigrants out.
And he's not a politician.
Let him know what you think of Trump.
We're tired of politicians.
He's the Greek corpse. He is, I've had enough of these guys, I'm mad as hell, I'm not gonna take it. And he speaks for the people in that way.
Donald Trump is like a 1950s B-movie. He just swallowed some plutonium and he blew up to be atomic regular guy. You know, he's just bigger. Everything he does is bigger. I'm bigger, I'm better, I'm more fabulous.
Is this a comic book version of a presidential campaign?
It's not a comic book, and it's not a very nicely asked question the way you say that.
I'm Donald Trump. I'm really rich. I'm really smart. I think I am a nice person. China, China, China! I'm gonna go kill all of you there and all of you in North Korea! And so, I would just like to say this. I'm going to be the next president.
To some, he represents the personification of the American dream, the consummate self-made man.
It has not been easy for me. And, you know, I started off in Brooklyn. My father gave me a small loan of $1 million. I came into Manhattan.
He's, you know, essentially a guy who was born on third base and has been telling everyone he hit a triple.
I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that to brag, because you know what? I don't have to brag. I don't have to, believe it or not.
By the way, let's just put this in perspective. You said it hasn't been easy for you, but my dad gave me $1 million
loan. No, he
loan.
Didn't.
That probably is going to seem
you're
pretty
right.
easy to a lot
you're
of people.
Right.
But $1 million isn't very much compared to what I built.
Donald Trump is not only one of my oldest, dearest friends, he's also an American success story. When he graduated college, he put his shoulder to the wheel, nose to the grindstone, borrowed $6 million from his father, and started a career.
But how can you say you're a self-made man when you're born into a real estate empire? Years before Donald ever plastered his name on a building, his father, Fred Trump, the son of a German immigrant, is bolstering the family's reputation and his personal fortune on construction projects all over New York.
Fred Trump was an extremely successful builder of public housing in Queens and in Brooklyn. It wasn't Manhattan. He was building housing for GIs returning from World War II. And he was one of a handful of developers in that era who got in early and became enormously wealthy doing that.
His father's a very frugal man. They used to talk about him walking his construction sites after the workers left around 6, he would walk around picking up nails and putting them back in the barrel for reuse.
When young Donald wants to spend time with his father, the boy visits construction sites. He's just five, he says, when he drives his first bulldozer. During the 60s, Fred Trump's development projects span the city. But the elder Trump lends his name to only one, Trump Village, a middle-class oasis near the faded amusements of Coney Island. Even then, the senior Trump seems self-conscious of the attention, a quality his son wouldn't inherit. In fact, he's been taught to believe the world's riches await him. The family's pastor is Norman Vincent Peale, author of The Power of Positive Thinking, an epically successful best-selling self-help guide that touts ambition as the source of enlightenment.
So on Sundays, Donald would sit with his family and they would listen to these sermons all about how you should be the best you can be.
You hated to leave church. You hated when the sermon was over. That's how great he was.
Donald's drive to succeed reveals itself when he's sent to the New York Military Academy. There he becomes a disciplined student and a competitive athlete. After finishing military school in 1964, Donald spends 2 years at Fordham University, a well-respected but largely working-class school in the Bronx, before transferring to the prestigious Wharton School of Business.
I'm really smart. Went to the Wharton School of Finance. Even then, a long time ago, like the hardest or one of the hardest schools to get into.
He talks a lot about how he went to the Wharton School, but he is not an Ivy League guy. Never has been, never will be. He's this rich guy who's appealing to people who, on some level, hate the rich.
He came out of Wharton with a real education in finance that exceeded his father's understanding.
Donald begins working at his father's Brooklyn office, and in 1971, is handed the reins of the company. He's 25 years old.
What kind of an offer are you looking for?
Well, we've had a number of offers from the wealthiest of Mideast sources, and for obvious reasons, we've declined.
I think Donald's always had a plan. I understand the fact that he did have money, but I've seen people come and go that have lost all their family fortune in a flash.
As he rolls around New York in a late model Cadillac, complete with a license plate bearing his initials, Donald is secure in both the family wealth and the political connections that come with it. Still, he's determined to earn success on his own terms. And his goals far exceed the world of New York real estate.
Donald always, always wanted to be president.
I would love and I would dedicate my life to this country.
Where are all the bright, honest, intelligent Americans ready to step in and save the nation and lead the way?
We don't have people like that in this country. Everybody's at the mall, scratching his ass, picking his nose, taking his credit card out of his fanny pack and buying a pair of sneakers with lights in them.
But I'm not a politician, I'm a business guy.
Mr. Deuce, some say you don't actually have a viable plan in place if you were to be elected president. Well, who said that, the turd sandwich?
This is somebody that we want for president? I don't think so. What I care about is the direction of this country. And what I'm very, very worried about is that it might go in the wrong direction with someone like Donald Trump. If you care about your future, vote for it.
You've got to get it through your thick head that what is presented to you as fact is normally anything but. You can call it a conspiracy theory and all you want. You still don't understand the stuff that you think is true is bullshit, and the stuff that you think is bullshit is true.
I mean, I'm not gonna just get elected, you know, and look like a jackass. Oh, jeez.
Now for something completely different.
Completely different.
Completely different.
Completely different.
completely different.